Stormbreast with you. This is now release event, but it's just an 8-4, so I don't have to have those confusing Swiss sealed or no, sorry, draft sealed. I mean, just confusing to me. 8-4 is what I know. I know and understand. So let's jump into it. I think Hypersonic Dragon. That's pretty clear first pick here. That's going to send me into Izzet, and maybe I get a Gilgate Gate back. You never know your luck. Though I'd be happy, I guess, with Lobbercrew. Copper Brute is fine, I guess. Hypersonic Dragon is a decent bomb to begin with. Passing Azorius Guildmage. Some average cards. Guildgates are good, obviously. Flyers are good. Right, Hypersonic Dragon. So taking a blue-red card first, that's going to lead me to blue, red, black, or blue, red, white. So with that in mind, the next pick, I think it's pretty easy. We'll just take Explosive Impact here. Rakdos Ringleader. I do not get this card. I don't get it. A 6 mana 3/1 first strike regenerator. It's expensive. First strike and regenerate together. I just don't get it. Explosive Impact, a card I get. Deal damage. Doesn't take a genius. Goes great. Not much else. I'm passing up. Axebane Guardian, I do like. Centaur Healer is a very good one. Azorius Arrester, I like a lot. Slime Molding, always fine. Okay. Now, not a whole lot going on. I think we'll just take the Guildgate here. Seems a solid pick. Keep my manas fixed. Now, depending on the blue that comes around, maybe not necessarily committed to blue. I mean, I'm going to be playing red for Explosive Impact, but we'll see how that goes. We're going to take the Guildgate here. There still is a curse, though. We'll see how it goes. Passing up on a Golgari Guildgate. Arrester. Frostburn Weird seems good. Skywatch is playable. I don't mind Skywatch, especially if loading up on the detain mechanic. Sky Knight, I think, is going quite late here. I think Sky Knight is very good. Three power flyer for three with a very relevant ability. I mean, the next best card, I mean, sticking to blue and red, Roomwing or Electricity, it's not even close. So let's go with Sky Knight here. So that might put me in blue, red, white. I do like Azorius, and Sky Knight is a reason that I do end up in Azorius. Here we've got 2/2 First Strike Unleash. That I like. I also like Azorius Guildgate, though. Havoc Festival. Have to be pretty darn aggressive for Havoc Festival to work. Beginning of each player's upkeep, they lose half their life. I'm not sure if this is a good limited card to play. It seems a bit too risky. So, that said, Splatterthug or Guildgate? I think I like Guildgate. If I'm going to be in three colors, I want to be taking the gates rather than playing, reasonable but unexciting dudes. So, now we've got this Racketeer might be the pick here, just as a guy. Minotaur Aggressor seems quite good for seven, as far as seven goes, which isn't so exciting. If in doubt, take the lower costing card, I think. Sounds uncommon. Okay, I'm gonna take Racketeer here. White, blue. Okay, so blue's the core color. Yeah, all right, I'm gonna take the Racketeer. I don't think white's gonna be. When it's a choice between a white card and a red card, I think I'd want to be leaning towards red at this stage. Two red cards versus my one white card. Here we can pick up Paralyzing Grasp. Not exciting, but it's removal and not a whole lot else going on. Concordia Pegasus, I guess you'd play, but not be excited about. Sure. Okay, I do like Rune Wing. Just So it's a flyer. Reasonable cost. Draws a card if you need to chump block or whatever. Chemist's Trick doesn't excite me at all. There's quite a number of cards that kind of do the same job as Chemist's Trick, and Chemist's Trick is just the worst of the lot, I think. So yeah, Runewing seems fine. Alright, and Izzet Guildgate did come back. So I can take that or Cobblebrute. I think I like the gate. And I can have my Rakdos Ringleader if I want him. Let's just take Swift Justice, I guess. At least it's in colors I'm looking to play. Though, an off-color Swift Justice does not excite me. Double white could be hard to cast, but if blue's my core color, cancel might make the cut. I'm not gonna play green or black. Conjured Currency. I don't know what you do with this in limited. I guess if your opponent's deck is much better than yours, Conjured Currency could be good. I suppose you exchange control and target permanent. All right. So if your opponent just has really good stuff, I don't know. I'm just gonna hide it, I think. It's kind of like confusion in the ranks out of Ravnica. It's just, what does this card even do? So, Pack Rat is quite a good card, I think, in limited. I'm not gonna take it though. I think we're just gonna go with Gorehouse Chainwalker. Two on Unleash seems strong. And that excites me more than these other cards. So I'm gonna have Heavy Red, I think. Yeah, let's give that a crack. Okay. Ooh. So some good cards here. I think I like Skymark Rock. I mean, it's gonna be that little bit more difficult to play it, but it is quite a good one. So I think that's what I'm gonna take here. Hopefully I can get maybe another Azorius Guildgate. Make my colors a bit easier. What I'm passing up on. Gutter Snipe could be good. I guess it only has to ping once or twice to get value in an aggressive deck. But Skymark Rock doesn't take any hoops to jump through, except for mana, which I think I can make the mana work. So we can. I think we're going to be annihilating here. Annihilating Fire removal spell is going to beat out anything else this pack offers me. Nothing too exciting here. I think Annihilating Fire is the best card. It depends how much a Nausea is worth, giving creatures minus one, minus one. Annihilating Fire is the best for me, though. Probably means that I'm not going to be playing Cancel. Double Blue is going to be a bit hard with Double Red. And getting white as well. Here there's some good black removal. Augur's Spree's very good. Stab Wound is solid as well. Is it worth my while splashing black as well? Don't think I think I'm fine for removal, actually. I don't think I need to splash out to black. Though it does disappoint me that these good black cards are coming around. So I guess I'm gonna take Tower Drake. Right, not excited about it, but it's fine. Alright, so I think I want to go aggressive. I think that's where I'm headed. So Cobblebrute is going to be preferable over Void Welder, I think. So let's do that. Okay. Nothing exciting here. I guess we'll just take another red guy. I mean, the loot is pretty appealing, so it's a dude and you get a loot, so that's pretty nice. What am I going to do with this pack? I mean, I could take Hussar Patrol. Can I make Fairy Imposter work? I can get value by returning Racketeer. Not the best value, but value. Sky Knight would be quite good to return. That's about it. So it's not too exciting. I think I still like it better than Hussar Patrol. I think if I can pick up some early drops, some two drops, Fairy Imposter contributes more to the board. So Crosstown Courier is another two drop. This might be the deck where I play Trumpet Blast with Dynacharge. I mean, I don't have a whole lot of evasion so far, but I'm looking to be aggressive, so it could work. I'm gonna take the two drop here though. All right, so anytime I need to pick up a Trumpet Blast, I should have that option. But I'm gonna take the two drops in the meantime. All right, I've got some choices here. Wow, they're all in my colors. So I can take the two drop Frostburn Weird. Should be quite good. I don't think Inspiration is what this deck wants. Traitorous Instinct could be good, but I don't think it's going to be as good as Frostburn Weird. So between Guttersnipe and the Weird, I don't have that many instants or sorceries. I'm going to take the Weird. I don't know if that's right, but it's a two drop. And quite a relevant two drop at that. Dead Revel is going late, but I'm just going to take Dispel. And a Rakdos Charm, why not? Doorkeeper's not a bad defensive card. Two mana naught for Defender. Interesting. So the moment I'm looking, is it Splash White? So I'm probably not playing Swift Justice, but Sky Knight and Skymark Rock are powerful enough to justify the White Splash, I think. Alright. Is it aggro? I think it is. All right, some serious options here. I could take Archon, obviously insane when it comes down, or I could just hedge my bets with Izzet Charm. This is really tough. So I mean, the shock counter, very very good. But Archon, if games go to seven, which I have seen them tend to do. Though it is in my off color. Maybe seven is just too much for what my deck is trying to do. I am trying to close out the game quite quickly. So it's going to have to be Izzet Charm, I think. And plus, Izzet Charm's on color as well. So there you go. It's sad, but hey. Seven is a lot. I'm looking to be aggressive, so. Ooh. Very nice. This is a fantastic. So this is the seven drop I don't mind playing. Cyclonic Rift. Returning all of my opponent's creatures, that's much more impactful at seven mana. Plus it's on color. Also can be played at two. So yeah. I wouldn't mind Teleportal either. Teleportal is gonna go quite nicely, but Cyclonic Rift is definitely the superior option. Okay. So, I've got Traitorous Instinct here, which is appealing to me. There's some removal spells. Trestani's Judgment is off color. Dramatic Rescue is a bounce effect. Could just take the 1/1 flyer. It's gonna be between Traitorous Instinct and Dramatic Rescue for me. I think Dramatic Rescue is gonna be the better spell. The only question is, how easily am I going to be able to cast it? Traitorous Instinct might even will. I think I'm going to take the Dramatic Rescue here. Hopefully, I can pick up some more fixing so that I can get to white, maybe another Azorius Guildgate, but I think Dramatic Rescue is going to be the more impactful card. Okay. So I'm not taking the double white Sunspire Griffin. So Tower Drake is going to be the option here. Pyroconvergence. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gold cards. How many do I need? Probably more than that, I should see. So yeah, we're gonna take the Tower Drake here. Fine way to set up my offensive, of course. Ah, this is a welcome pick. Azorius Key Rune solves my minor troubles, and if I don't need the fixing, making a 2/2 flyer very relevant to my interests. So let's go with that. What does this do? Put a 2/2 knight into play. Okay. So, what does this do? Whenever it's dealt damage, flip a coin. If you lose, sacrifice it. When it dies, flip a coin. If you lose the flip, it deals 4 damage to each creature and each player. Wow. That's a lot of coin flips. Coin flip, man. I don't remember ever seeing this card in spoilers. Attacks each turn if able. Wow. Yeah, let's just take the Spider Thug, I think. yeah. Okay, so I can take the 6-drop Skywatch. There's a flyer, it's got a relevant ability. I do like those things going for it. It's high land, so I'm looking for another card here. I do like Traitorous Instinct. How greedy can I get? I mean, because I could probably get Skywatch here and then Traitorous Instinct later. Which one's more important to me? 6 is a lot, but I like what Skywatch does for me. Maybe I should just go with Traitorous Instinct, actually. It's what my deck's trying to do. I'm not looking to survive to 6, I don't think. Here between Electricory and Gorehouse Chainwalker, I think just take the 2-drop. Is it aggro? Is it aggro? That's the question you've got to ask yourself. Alright, and I did get a Guildgate, so I'm very happy with that. I do not want Promenade, not at all. I want to be able to play my 2-drops. And then a 3-drop following. So Guildgate assists in doing that. Promenade is going to disrupt the curve too much. Right, and I do have the option of Dynacharge. I mean, I think it's just going to be better. I'm going to hide Paralyzing Grasp. That's not going to make the cut. I think it's just going to be better playing Traitorous Instinct than Dynacharge. So I'm going to take a trick. Maybe Chemist's Trick. Right, Dead Revel is still going around. I could have been a... Could have been an interesting aggro deck going blue-red-black. That's okay, blue-red-white's offered me good things as well. I'm gonna cut it. Alright, and Tenement Crasher, I can play. Don't intend to, but... Now, Monitor is quite a good card, I think. 3-3 Trampler. Yeah, let's take that one. Sure. Right, let's build it up. Make sure I get these 2-drops, and I like the Unleash guys for my aggressive deck as well. Cobblebrute I like as well. Traitorous Instinct. So Fairy Imposter I am gonna make work with my assortment of 2-drops. What else we got? Not search warrant, sorry. 21. Alright, so I can just play the 2 Racketeers and that makes 23. Anything I feel left out? Not really. I think that looks pretty good. Let's see what the land suggestion is. 773. Alright, so... All of my gates make blue, piles by color. So number of blue cards, I'm gonna have to have quite a bit more Mountains and islands. I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 blue. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Oh, I know. 12 red. Okay. Yeah, well, I will need more mountains than islands, obviously. So, how many planes do I want to put in? Maybe two planes? That gives me four sources, five sources actually, with Kieran. So two planes. Let's give a suggestion here. Two planes. And one more mountain. That makes eight red sources, eight blue sources. Oh wait, hang on. Nine, 10 blue sources. 10 blue sources, eight red sources. I think that should be enough. I only need double red for annihilating fire. But obviously I need blue for anything else. All right, I think eight reds and yeah. That should be good. All right. Let's go with this.